Hi friends, good morning. Welcome to Maitri's Kitchen. So today recipe is again an all-time favorite, which is our instant parota. We have already shown how to do soft parota, but today we are going to do how to make our instant parota. The main ingredient is of course our maida. I have taken 200 ml of maida along with 75 ml of boiled milk, 2 to 3 tablespoons of butter which is melted, along with the required amount of water. We will be using salt as per requirement and 2 tablespoons of refined oil. So let us see how do we do our instant parota. I have add the 200 ml of maida flour. I am going to add the required amount of salt. I have added the required amount of salt. Now I am adding 1 tablespoon of melted butter. With that, I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of oil. Mix everything well so that the oil gets mixed well with our flour. So friends, you can find the oil and the salt is nicely mixed in the dough. At this stage, I'm going to add the measured boiled milk little by little and nicely mix the dough with the milk. Parota dough is almost getting ready. It's become so soft. You can find it here. You can find it so very soft. So now let us start doing our parota one by one. On a plate, I've just added a tablespoon of butter. I'm just spreading the butter in the plate. We are not going to use any other thing. We are just going to flatten the parota in the plate. So I'm just going to make balls. Then we will see what is next. Plate, we're just adding 1/2 tablespoon of oil. Spread the oil gently. Now spread 1 dough of our maida flour. Just keep it here and spread it with your center palm as much as possible. We have just flattened in our palms itself. So now just take a knife and cut it to a straight pieces. Just like this. Now we need to roll this like this so that you get layer parotas. Don't worry about the shape, we just need to get the layers. So just roll it like this. Just make a round and insert this bottom in the bottom like this. And again spread it with your palm. Just add little oil to your palm so that you get a wider round. Keep it in the center and just spread it as much as possible. Layer parota is almost come. Now keep the tawa on. You can find the parota will come very nicely. It's coming out. So keep the tawa on and let us fry it. Is ready. So now we are going to put our layered parota one by one. So I made a small parota. You can make, if you wanted a bigger one, I made mini parotas. So I'm just adding 1 tablespoon of butter. You can add either oil, but butter will give more nice taste. So cook it to a brownish, golden brownish color. You can find our mini parota is almost cooked well. Just remove this. It's come out so very soft. Just place it aside. Now let us put another mini parota. So friends, you can find our mini parotas for our lovely kids. How well it has come out. So soft and crispy. I can also show you one. You can just see one parota. You can just find it. It is so very soft and it has come in layers. You can also find this. So please keep trying in the same way. Measurement should be the main thing for doing our parota. Have the proper measurement and try doing our lovely parota. If you make this parota a wider one and a bigger one, it becomes a normal parota. I have made a small parota for kids. So try this mini parota at home. So watch my video, share my video, subscribe to my channel. We'll come up with another yummy recipe shortly. Happy cooking. Stay safe. Bye-bye.